Hello, and welcome to the unveiling of another Marvels of Biology ant colony. Many of you have already met the Carpenters, a Camponotus novaburrisensis colony that is growing and thriving right now. But now it is time to meet the Tetramorium species E, or pavement ant, colony. First, let's learn a bit about some of the differences between the carpenter ants and these pavement ants. Starting with one of the most obvious differences, length. From antenna to the end of the abdomen, one of my carpenter ant workers is around 1/4 to 3/8 of an inch, or around 7 to 9 millimeters long, with the queen around 3/4 of an inch, or 19 millimeters long. For ants native to my area, this is relatively large. The pavement ant queens I've captured this year have been around 3/8 of an inch long, close to 9 millimeters, and only about half the length of a carpenter ant queen with significantly less girth. Pavement ant workers, which were very difficult to measure, were about 1/8 of an inch long, or around 3 millimeters, way smaller than a carpenter ant worker. Pavement ants are an invasive species here, likely arriving through commerce and thought to have originated in Europe. They have been a very effective invader, displacing some of the local ant species through competition and possibly predation. Even though these ants are tiny, they are formidable and commonly seen swarming food and prey. Unlike the carpenters, which can spray an irritating substance called formic acid from their abdominal tips, pavement ants have a sting that can be used to immobilize prey and threats. Fortunately, they aren't known to be extremely aggressive, nor are their stings as potent as the well-known invasive ant, the fire ant. In fact, depending on how thick a larger animal's skin is, a pavement ant might not even be able to penetrate deep enough to effectively deliver its payload. Finally, a big difference for ant keepers to be aware of is that their life cycle is nearly twice as fast as carpenter ants, and the queen can lay much larger clutches of eggs. Combined, this means once they get going, pavement ant colonies can explode in number. It's amazing how different life strategies can yield such dramatic differences in the behavior and success of animals. What I didn't know was that I'd witness yet another interesting life strategy. For the Tetramorium colony featured in this video, I did something differently than with the carpenter ant queen. To help this young queen's colony explode successfully, I gathered pupae from a wild Tetramorium colony and introduced them to her test tube. In the world of ant keeping, this is called brood boosting, the process where brood from another colony are introduced to a captive colony to increase their strength and fitness of a young colony by supplying a new queen with new workers faster. I gave our pavement ant queen 5 carefully selected pupae, and within a few days, she helped the first worker a close. Oh, and as you may have noticed, there is yet another different scene here. Unlike carpenter ants that spin silken cocoons to pupae in, pavement ants pupae in the buff. That's right, no silk pajamas here, it all happens in plain sight. Then another worker was closed. But what I saw next was shocking. Pavement ant queens are known to occasionally eat their own eggs, often thought of as a stress response or as a way of recycling proteins and keeping the starting brood small. The exact reason isn't known. But what I caught on camera, I couldn't find mention of in any scholarly journals. Maybe it has been documented, but it certainly came as a surprise to me, and if it hasn't been documented, well, here it is. The pavement ants had killed and began eating one of their pupae. Well, at this point, I wasn't sure that they killed it, because it was still white and there is a chance I could have damaged it in the transfer. They are incredibly fragile. But, to my knowledge, cannibalism is not entirely common in ants. Even among warring colonies, the dead are often sent to gravesites instead of being consumed. These Tetramorium ants were chowing down on one of their sisters, though. To To us humans, this can certainly be shocking, but to the ants, the capability to use this strategy grants many benefits. Maybe this behavior is one of the reasons Tetramorium ants have succeeded so well as an invasive species. The remaining two pupae looked to be developing well and were turning from a pale white to a deep orange brown as they got closer to a closing. Eventually, a third sister entered the mix, and, by this point, the queen's own brood appeared to be developing quite well. The last pupa was turning orange and would certainly close soon, but wait, the last pupa, that I knew was still alive and healthy since I could see it developing, was also to become food for the colony. This confirmed it. They were harvesting their living, pupating sisters to feed the rest of the brood. It didn't seem to be a lack of food that brought on this behavior, and they had been undisturbed for a few days prior to me catching them in the act. This makes stress or lack of food less likely as a reason, so I'm not sure on the exact reason why they resorted to cannibalism, but it might simply be that this species, that has been well known for queens that will eat their own eggs, might exhibit full-on cannibalism at many stages in the colony's life. Many ants, perhaps most notably Dracula ants, practice a type of partial cannibalism where the ants will make a small wound on pupae or larvae and drink the hemolymph or ant blood. In these cases, the offspring that are fed on heal and live normal lives. With our pavement ants, there was no chance of normal life, since they devoured the entire pupa, casing and all. This was an amazing discovery, and to have caught the process not once, but twice on camera was truly a stroke of luck. Well, at least for us and the queen's brood, maybe not so much for the two pupae who became dinner. These pavement ants, so common and often overlooked, are truly marvels of biology. Be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon to get notifications when new updates and videos come out. And as always, thank you for watching.